Sairam children, good morning. Yes, look at these pictures. Who is he? Yes, Saint Namdev. And he is Saint Tukaram. Saint Samarth Ramdas. Now look at the sacred book. The sacred book is, yes, Jnaneshwari. Who wrote Jnaneshwari? Yes, Saint Jnaneshwar. So today we are going to study about Saint Jnaneshwar in chapter 13, Saint Jnaneshwar. Jnaneshwar was one of the greatest saints of Maharashtra. He was the second of the four children of Vithalpan and Rukmabai. Vithalpan, though married, wanted to become a sannyasi. So he went to Varanasi in Uttar Pradesh. He met Ramanand Swami and requested him to initiate him into sannyas, and Swami Ramanand agreed. But Vithalpan did not reveal that he was married. Once Ramanand happened to visit Alandi, where Rukmabai, the wife of Vithalpan, stayed. Rukmabai had his darshan and Ramanand blessed her and said, "You will have many children." Then Rukmabai told him that her husband had left the home to take sannyas. Immediately Ramanand Swami realized that Vithalpan, who took sannyas from him, was her husband. So he returned to Kashi and ordered Vithalpan to return home to his family in Alandi. Three sons and a daughter were born to them. They were Nivrutinath, Jnandev, Sobhan and Muktabai, daughter. But the family was outcasted because the orthodox Brahmins in Alandi believed that it was against the scriptures to return to householder's life after taking sannyas. Once Vithalpan went to Trimbak in Nasik with his children. While they were walking on the hill, a tiger suddenly appeared. Seeing it, all of them ran away. Vithalpan, Jnandev, Sobhan and Muktabai reached home safely. Nivrutinath got separated because he took shelter in a cave. In that cave, he met a saint named Jnaninath, who initiated him and taught him the mysteries of yoga and the spiritual knowledge. Then Jnaninath asked Nivruti to teach this to his Jnandev, his brother. So children, Jnaneshwar, he was one of the greatest saints of Maharashtra and he was the second of the four children of Vithalpan and Rukmabai. Now Vithalpan, though he was married, but he wanted to become a sannyasi. So what did he do? He went to Uttar Pradesh, that is Varanasi in Uttar Pradesh. And whom did he meet there? He met Ramanand Swami and requested him to initiate him into sannyas. And Ramanand Swami agreed. But what Vithalpan do? He kept a secret. That is, he did not reveal that he was married. Now after some days and all, once when Ramanand Swami happened to visit Alandi, where Rukmabai, the wife of Vithalpan, so who was Rukmabai, wife of Vithalpan, she had his darshan and Ramanand blessed him that she will have many children. That time what Rukmabai told, she told that her husband had left home to take sannyas. Then Ramanand Swami realized that Vithalpan, who took sannyas from him, was her husband. So he returned to Kashi and ordered Vithalpan to return home. And then three sons and a daughter were born to them. They were Nivrutinath, Jnandev, Sobhan and Muktabai. So three were sons and Muktabai daughter. Now what happened children? The family was outcasted because the orthodox Brahmins in Alandi, they believed that it was against the scriptures that once if you have become sannyasi, you cannot return to your householder's life and have children. Then what happened? Once when Vitalbandi went to Trimbak in Nasik with his children, and while they were walking, a tiger suddenly appeared, and seeing it, all of them ran away. Vitalpan, Nyandes, Sopan and Muktabai, they reached home safely. But Nivrutinath, he got separated because he took shelter in cave. And there, whom did he meet? He met Saint Nyaninath, who initiated him and taught him the mysteries of yoga and spiritual knowledge. Then Nyaninath asked Nivruti to teach this to Nyandev, his brother. Nivrutinath then returned home and everyone became happy. He narrated the story as to how he entered the cave and how the guru initiated him, etc. Then he also told that the guru has instructed him to initiate his brother. Thus, Nivrutinath, his brother, became the guru of Nyandev. Later, the parents Vitalpan and Rukmabai approached the learned Brahmin scholars and requested them to perform the thread ceremony of their sons. When Vitalpan introduced Nyandev first, one of the Brahmins said, "If he is Nyandev, there is no need for him to learn." Other Brahmins laughed. Just then, they all heard a voice of the village waterman, prodding his buffalo, Nyana. Again, that Brahmin had asked Vitalpan, "What is the difference between your Nyandev and the buffalo Nyana?" As the assembly of Brahmins burst into laughter, Nyandev's soft voice was heard. "There's no difference at all." At the same time, the waterman whipped the buffalo Nyana. The next moment, the parents, looking at the marks on the back of Nyandev, shouted with fear, "Oh Nyanoba!" Then the Brahmins also looked and remarked, "What lash marks on his back? It's astounding." Though the Brahmins were surprised, one of them asked Nyandeva, "If there's no difference between him and the buffalo, whether that buffalo could recite the Vedas?" Immediately, Nyandev walked out and approached the buffalo and prayed, "Chant the Vedas, Lord." To the utter amazement of the gathering, the buffalo was heard reciting the Vedas in a deep, resonant voice. Then the Brahmins were overwhelmed with awe and praised Nyandev and said, "We will be happy to perform your thread ceremony." At this juncture, Swami Ramanand appeared on the scene and told Vitalpan that the purpose for which he sent him back to his family was accomplished. Now Vitalpan and his wife might go to Badrinath for performing tapasya. Looking at Nyandev, Ramanand remarked, "Nyandeva, it is the Lord's will that you should spread the teachings of Bhagavad Dharma." In reply, Nyandev remarked, "I am but an instrument in his hand. I will do his will." So children, when Nivrutinath returned home, everyone became happy. At that time he narrated the story as to how he entered the cave and how the guru initiated him. And he also said that the guru has instructed him to initiate his brother. So Nivrutinath became the guru of Nyandev. Now later on children, the parents of Nyandev, that is Vitalpan and Rukmabai, they approached the learned Brahmins scholars and requested them to perform the thread ceremony of their sons. So we know children, in the Hindu culture and all, Hindu religion, that of the boys and all, we have the thread ceremony. So here also they wanted to have the thread ceremony of their sons. And for that Vitalpan, he introduced Nyandev first. And one of the Brahmins, he said, "Now if he is Nyandev," because his name was Nyandev, means already he is having the knowledge, Nyan, knowledge. So there is no need for him to learn. And for this, all the other Brahmins, they laughed. And that time only, they heard that one village waterman he was brooding his buffalo. And what was the buffalo's name? Even the buffalo's name was a Sunyan. So the head of the Brahmins, he asks Vithalpan, now what is the difference between your son Nyandev and that buffalo Nyans? Again the Brahmins, they burst into laughter. And Nyandev's soft voice said, there is no difference at all. And same time the waterman, he whipped the buffalo Nyan. And that time also, the lash marks were seen on the back of Nyandev. And their parents, they in with fear and all, they said, oh Nyanuba. And seeing this, the Brahmins and all, they remark. And it was astounding, surprising how that the waterman, village waterman, he lashed the buffalo. That is, whipped the buffalo. But the lash marks were seen on Nyandev's back. And that time was what the Nyandev did. That is, he said there's no difference between the buffalo and him. So the Brahmin said that buffalo could recite the Vedas. So immediately you can see these children, buffalo, Nyandev and the Brahmin. And that time the Nyandev, he walked out and he approached the buffalo. So he's praying and he's praying and he's saying, buffalo is a lord, chant the Vedas lord. And you can see, Om is written, see, picture children. So from this we come to know that to the utter amazement, always surprised, amazed, that the buffalo was heard reciting the Vedas. And that also you can see, clear, loud voice. So then the Brahmins were overwhelmed and they praised that they will surely, they were happy to perform the thread ceremony. And that at that juncture, the same time, even the Swami Ramanand, he appeared on the scene. You can see children. And he told Vithalpan that the purpose for which he was sent back to the family is accomplished. So now what he has to do? Vithalpan and his wife, Rukmabai, they might go to, they'd go to Badrinath for performing tapasya. And even looking at the Namdev, Ramanand remarked, Namdev, it is the Lord's will, Lord, God's will, that you should spread the teachings of Bhagavad Dharma. And what the reply Nyandev gave, he said that he is instrument in God's hand, his hand, and he will do. One day, Nyandev, his brothers and sisters were sitting on a wall. Suddenly, Nyandev saw a yogi approaching them and said, look, it's Yogi Changdev on a tiger. He is coming to meet us. Let us not get down. Nyandev then ordered the wall, move forward towards the sage. The wall started moving. Changdev was wonderstruck. He said, Nyandev can make even a lifeless wall move. He jumped off the tiger. So children, look this is another incident. One incident we saw how the buffalo was chanting the Vedas. And second incident, see, once they were sitting on a wall, Namdev, Nirutinath, Sopandev and Muktabai, see all the four, they are sitting on a wall. And that time the Namdev, he pointed out that Rishi Changdev is coming on a tiger. So when we see the Rishi and all saint, we should bow them. But here what they said, ki we will not get down. But what he did, he ordered the wall to move. See, the wall is moving towards the Rishi. That is same. And then that the Chang there, he said, when he can move the lifeless wall, move. He was wonderstruck. He had no words. You can see from this, children, is another incident. Then he walked towards them and said that he had set out to meet Nyandev and humble him. But he was wrong. He prostrated before Nyandev and pleaded him to forgive and accept him as a disciple and teach him. Later, Nyandev explained the mysteries of life and the universe to Changdev. News of Changdev's submission to Nyandev spread far and wide and hundreds of people flocked daily to Alandi to meet the man who had won over the great yogi. By this time, Gyandev began to explain the Bhagavad Gita in chaste and simple Marathi to the people who approached him. Once, Gyandev, by spiritual powers, cured Sachidanand Baba from a dangerous illness. Sachidanand Baba then became his disciple and helped Gyandev in writing Gyaneshwari, a commentary on Bhagavad Gita. It seems a pillar is still shown at Nivasi, where they wrote Gyaneshwari. Gyandev wrote Gyaneshwari when he was only 13 years old. His commentary on the Gita is considered to be the best. Later, Gyandev was elected as the president by the Sanskrit Pandits in Varanasi. Nivruti, the guru of Gyandev, also asked him to write a treatise on his spiritual experiences, which is known as Amrutanubhav. This book contains 800 couplets. Gyandev then, with his brothers and sisters, visited places of pilgrimage from north to south, including Rameshwaram and Madurai. It was at Pandharpur that Gyandev met Namdev, a devotee of Pandarinath. They became spiritual friends. Gyandev had a vast following of disciples. The prominent among them were Namdev, Janabai, Narhari, Chokhamela, Sena and Gorakumbha. Gyandev soon expressed his wish to enter into Sanjivani Samadhi, a Samadhi while alive. At the young age of 22, he gave up his physical body at Alandi while performing Kirtan and meditating on God. Nivrutinath placed a slab on the Samadhi of Gyandev. This can still be seen before the temple of Siddheshwara in Alandi. So children, another incident is about Sachidanand Baba. Gyandev, by spiritual powers, cured him. And Sachidanand Baba became his disciple and helped Gyaneshwari in writing Gyaneshwari. Now we know Gyaneshwari, it is a commentary on Bhagavad Gita. And his commentary is considered to be the best. We know, children, that Bhagavad Gita is written in Sanskrit. Now, common man do not understand it. So, he wrote it in Marathi so that common man can understand it. So, his commentary is considered to be the best. Then later, Gyandev was elected as the president by the Sanskrit Pandits. And Gyandev, with his brothers and sisters, visited places of pilgrimage from north to south, including Rameshwaram and Madurai. And it was at Pandharpur he met Namdev, a great devotee of Pandarinath, and they became spiritual friends. And Gyandev's disciples were increasing day by day, vast following of disciples. Gyandev soon expressed his desire or his wish to enter into Sanjivani Samadhi or Samadhi while alive at the young age of 22. Children, young age of 22, he gave up his physical body at Alandi while performing Kirtan and meditating on God. Nivrutinath, his guru, his brother, he placed a slab on the Samadhi of Gyandev. So children, look at this. This is Samadhi of Gyandev. It is in Alandi.
देवाचिये द्वारी उभाशन भरी तेरे मुक्तिचारी साधीला देवाचिये द्वारी उभाशन भरी हरि मुके मना पुण्याची गणना कोण करी देवाचिये द्वारी उभाशन भरी असोनी संसारी जीवे वेगुकरी वेदशास्त्र उभारी भाय सदा देवाचिये द्वारी उभाशन भरी तेने मुक्तिचारी साधिला ज्ञानदेव म्हणे व्यासाची खूणे द्वारकेचे राणे पांडवा घरी देवाची द्वारी उभाशनवरी तेने मुक्तिचारी साधिला देवाची द्वारी उभाशनवरी। संत ज्ञानेश्वर आपल्या हरिपाठामध्ये सांगतात की देवाच्या द्वारामध्ये म्हणजे देवाच्या दारामध्ये तुम्ही क्षणभर उभे राहिलात तरी तुम्हाला चारही प्रकारच्या ज्या मुक्ती आहे त्या प्राप्त होऊ शकतात, म्हणजे चारही प्रकारची मुक्ती तुम्हाला मिळू शकते। त्यासाठी दिवस देवळामध्ये घालवण्याची किंवा दिवसभर देवाचं करण्याची काही गरज नाही, फक्त क्षणभर जरी देवाचं नामस्मरण केलं तरी भरपूर झालं। हरी मुके मना पुण्याची गणना कोण करी। संत ज्ञानेश्वर म्हणतात की तुम्ही तुमच्या मुखातून हरीचं म्हणजे परमेश्वराचं तुम्ही फक्त नाव घ्या तर तुम्हाला सगळ्या प्रकारचं म्हणजे पूर्ण भरपूर पुण्य तुम्हाला प्राप्त होईल आणि इतकं पुण्य प्राप्त होईल की आपल्याला त्याचं मोजमापही करता येणार नाही, इतकं भरभरून पुण्य तुम्हाला प्राप्त होईल फक्त आपल्या मुखातून हरीचं नाव घेतलं तरी। असोनी संसारी जीवे वेगू करी वेदशास्त्र उभारी बाह्य सदा। आपण संसारामध्ये राहून देवाचं नामस्मरण करायचं, त्यासाठी संसार त्याग करायची काही गरज नाही, म्हणजे संसार सोडून द्यायचा, कर्तव्य सोडून द्यायची काही आपल्याला गरज नाही। आपण संसारामध्ये राहून देवाचं फक्त नाव घेतलं पाहिजे आणि ते नाव घेताना आपल्या जीवेने म्हणजे आपल्या जीभेने जीभेला वेग पाहिजे, म्हणजे आपल्या शब्दाला वेग पाहिजे, वेगाने त्या देवाचं नामस्मरण आपण केलं पाहिजे। आणि हे फक्त ज्ञानेश्वर म्हणतात मीच नाही सांगत तर वेदशास्त्रामध्ये सुद्धा हेच सांगितलं आहे, वेदशास्त्रसुद्धा भरभरून हे सांगतात की फक्त देवाचं नाव घ्या। ज्ञानदेव म्हणे व्यासाचीये खुणे द्वारकेचे राणे पांडवा घरी। ज्ञानदेव म्हणतात म्हणजे ज्ञानेश्वर म्हणतात की व्यासाचीये खुणे म्हणजे व्यास मुनींनी सुद्धा आपल्याला हेच सांगितलेलं आहे की द्वारकेचा राणा म्हणजे द्वारकेचे राणे म्हणजे श्रीकृष्ण, द्वारकेचा राजा श्रीकृष्ण हा पांडवा घरी राहिला, अखंड पांडवा घरी राहिला। मग पांडवांनी काय केलं तर त्यांनीसुद्धा नेहमी आपल्या परमेश्वराचं नाव घेतलं, मग श्रीकृष्णसुद्धा त्यांच्या घरी तो अखंड तिथे त्यांच्यासोबत राहिला। हे व्यासमुनी आपल्याला प्रमाण देतात, म्हणजे आपल्याला व्यासमुनी हे खरं सांगतात। तेच ज्ञानेश्वर आपल्याला सांगतात की या सगळ्या उदाहरणातून हेच आपल्याला लक्षात येतं की फक्त देवाचं नाव जरी आपण क्षणभर घेतलं तरी आपल्याला सगळ्या प्रकारचं पुण्य प्राप्त होतं आणि हे वेदशास्त्रामध्ये पण सांगितलेलं आहे आणि व्यासांनीसुद्धा आपल्याला सांगितलेलं आहे।
सो चिल्ड्रन, इन दिस पोयम सेंट ज्ञानेश्वर संत ज्ञानेश्वर इज सेइंग दॅट वी शुड टेक द नेम ऑफ गॉड, that is naam sankirtan, we should do naam sankirtan, take the name of God and that only will take us to liberation, and for that we have to take just name of God maybe for few moments, for second, and then only we will be able to go ahead in the spiritual path. And same thing he said, it is mentioned in the Ved Shastra, Vedas, and this is also said by Vyasji, Vyas Muni. So we should take the name of the God, and this is also the evidences that Dwarkadish, that is the Lord Krishna, he also stayed with Pandavas. So we should take the name of the Lord, that is Naam Sankirtan. Remember, the greatness of a person lies in his or her humility, not in scholarship or riches, said by Shrima. Shrima is saying that we should be humble. The greatness of a person lies in his or her humility, humbleness, and not in स्कॉलरशिप और रिचेस। मैक्सिम, संतः स्वतः प्रकाशन्ते, गुणा न पढ़तो नृणया। ग्रेट पीपल डेमोन्स्ट्रेट देयर क्वालिटीज ऑन देयर ओन एंड नॉट बाय अदर्स डिक्लेरेशन। सो ग्रेट पीपल डेमोन्स्ट्रेट देयर क्वालिटीज ऑन देयर ओन नॉट बाय अदर्स डिक्लेरेशन। सो थैंक यू चिल्ड्रन। साईराम।